Sean.
Oh, good morning.
I'm not going to ask you how you are on the phone. I think I'll ask you how you are over lunch today.
Oh, Sean.
Great. It's a date, then.
No. Not a bit to talk about getting back with Duke. I don't know how much more final I can be about that. Particularly since our discovery has another secret for me that there's just no use.
Whether we have lunch or not, we are going to meet today, and that's an order from your old WSB boss, Anna.
All right. I'll come by the warehouse later on. Will that do?
Certainly will. See you later.
From this moment on, we live only in the present.
Yes. Only in the present.
The sonnet my mother loved was the line I remember. It's for us now.
What is it?
Love is not love which alters when at alterations find.
Lovely.
What is for us? Our love is one true.
I think we'll order that now.
You are right, my love. That's what tonight is for.
Glad you like it.
I love it. Why did such short music?
I found it about 2 months ago. And I took a lease under an anonymous name, of course.
Really? Why anonymous?
In case a certain lady wanted it that way. I even remember the exact date.
When was it?
About 2 days after we met. I took a drive and I saw this sign. So I took a look, and I said to myself, this is for Anna Devane.
Hey, Duke. Duke,
oh. Hi, I'm sorry. What can I do for you, Sean?
I'd like you to come up to my office for a little talk.
Okay, I'll just get the manifest to give it
up. No, don't worry about that. I'm not going to discuss business.
If this is about Anna, right?
Yes, it is.
I appreciate what you're doing. I don't want any more questions.
There are going to be more questions, my friend. This time I aim to get some answers. See you in a couple minutes.
Anna was right about me.
Exactly what is she right about?
I have a secret that I can't share with her, but it's the final straw.
From what I gather, there were quite a few of those.
Yeah, this was a dead end.
I certainly hope it isn't the one concerning Comedia, because I could never understand why you kept your relationship with her a secret in the first place.
Sean, this has got to stop.
Now, I get the feeling that if she never reappeared in your life, we wouldn't have this problem now.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay. You started off on shaky ground here, my friend. And people from your past have a way of popping up into your life again.
Yeah, you know, but when you're in love, you somehow hope that won't happen.
Yeah, but it did.
Okay, so I gambled and I lost.
What do you mean you lost? What about Anna?
I know what I'm doing to Anna. I feel bad about it. It's killing me.
You know what I think? I think Pandora's box has been opened. Secret's about ready to escape if it hasn't already.
It hasn't. My father died to keep that secret. And it will die with me also.
And you're the only one left who knows the secret.
Yes.
What about your Aunt Janet?
She'll never know it.
Look, Duke, you and I are two guys that lived in a fast lane. Me, probably more than you. What are you trying to do? Protect Anna?
Of course, yes.
But you're not doing a very good job of it.
What does that mean?
What it means is that a secret has a life of its own. I mean, Angus died because of it. You could die because of it, but the secret, that'll survive. Somehow, some way, it will survive. Now, is that any way to protect Anna? To leave something like that to threaten her?
I think it will die with me.
I don't. When I was in the WSB, I dealt with secrets every day. Every day. Only rarely have I ever run across one that dies and goes away forever. But besides all that, there's something else we have to consider here.
What?
It might just be a solution.
Oh, there isn't a solution. Good God, man. Do you think I haven't looked for one?
Well, what about Anna? She might come up with one. She's right.
I could never take this to Anna.
All right, then what about me? I mean, isn't she worth fighting for?
Of course she is, yes.
Look, I have kept so many secrets in my life. But if I pick up that phone over there, hundreds of people might die. Because I said one word, and that's all it takes. So my protecting you and Anne is no big problem for me.
About 4 years ago. Give or take a month or two. Camille and I, we were in love. It never became a full-blown affair, but I suppose it could have done. I found out we were brother and sister. I was her half-brother, Angus. Was our father. When I told Camille this, well, I made her stronger stuff than she is, but well, she was shattered. I tried to hold her steady, but she spun off out of control. She went to the ballroom. She was dancing with a man who had come to the ball with Angus. He was a stranger to me. Angus was watching the couple with growing concern. He told me the man could be dangerous. He said we should get Camille away from there as soon as the music stopped. And by the time the music stopped, Camille had disappeared.
Where'd she go?
She hadn't gone very far. My father and I, we were in the hallway when we heard her scream. We were the only people to hear her scream. Nobody else was around. When we got into Camille's room, the man had tried to rape me. And Camille had killed
him. There's more, isn't there?
Her face. Camille's face. When she looked up and she saw us, it was as if she... It was like we were strangers. And then she closed her eyes. I carried her to a small guest room nearby. Angus told me what we had to do. He said we had to hide the body forever. And after we had the body, we had to go back to Camellia and swear her to secrecy. Well, when we got back to her, we couldn't swear her to anything. When she came to, she had no memory of what happened. Even after a year in a psychiatric hospital, she had no memory. She doesn't remember any of it, not even to this day. So do you see why I can't take this story to Anna? I mean, Anna, of all people.
Yeah, I can see it. She's chief of police. Compromises her job if she knew a crime like this existed.
And Miss Robin. God knows she went through enough when I went to prison. There really is. There's no end to this. There is no solution.
There never is an easy solution.
There certainly isn't one to this. Now do you understand?
Yes, I do.
You know, she lives a free. Except the blood has just drained right out of me.
Well, I'll make a recommendation. No, I'll turn that into an order.
What is that, my friend?
I want you to take a few days off, get out of town. Because if you don't, you're going to crack up.
I can't.
You're going to have to. You're going to have to get out of Port Charles. I mean, isn't there some place you can go, some place where you can find some peace?
I don't know. Perhaps I... I mean, there really is no... Rather than running away from any of this, there is no solution.
There might not be a solution, but there just might be a remedy.
I don't understand what you mean.
Well, you get right down to it, I don't either. But something's nagging at me. In time. Have a seat.
Can't sit still for very long, Sean, I'm afraid.
How's my godchild these days?
She's all right. A bit quiet. Did you bring me over here to talk about these again?
Yes.
Please don't. There's nothing more to be said. Getting very wary of my friends.
Why? Because everyone wants to help?
And everyone wants to offer me advice, and it's gone beyond that. And I wish you'd all accept it.
I can't accept it.
You must.
No, I'm sorry. You're going to have to hear me out because I owe it to Robin and to Robert, so I'll risk your anger.
I don't want to get angry at you, Sean. I just don't want you to give me any more advice or anyone else.
This might not come under the heading of advice. What I'm going to say, I don't think...
Please don't. I said I didn't...
I don't give a damn. You're going to hear me out anyway. Sit down. We're in the WSB together. We dealt with secrets every day of the week. We also dealt with trust... and betrayal, right?
Right.
Okay. Now, Duke has a secret he will not reveal to you. But aren't we all entitled to a couple of secrets in our life? I mean, sometimes they cover mistakes, and sometimes they cover sins.
Listen to me.
I'm not finished.
We're not dealing with just one secret here. There's been loads of them. There's never been any feeling of trust or faith in me.
Well, maybe they all add up to the ultimate secret.
When you love each other, there shouldn't be any secrets between you.
Anna, you are looking for utopia.
Why not?
You know what I think you should do? I think you should get off that high horse of yours and drop this holier-than-thou attitude.
You can't talk to me like that.
I'm the only one in Port Charles.
No!
I want you to listen to me.
Why should I? When you persistently refuse to understand, you think that I'm breaking up with you because of some indiscretion he had with Camellia? That's just a drop in the bucket. This has been going on from the first time I met him. It's just been a string of lies, a string of betrayals against the trust I felt that we shared. It's just gone on and on and on, Sean.
What a hypocrite you are.
What?
Do you want to take a moment here and discuss a trust and betrayal of me when you worked for me in the WSB? Or the damage done to some people's lives when you played around with being a double agent? You're not answering my question.
No, Sean, I'm not going to.
You talk about secrets, lady.
How can you be so cruel?
You want to know how?
Yes.
I would never have brought up your past unless I thought it would help save your future.
Well, that's very holier than thou.
You know, I can remember you coming to me and begging for forgiveness. I remember you trying to make it up to me. I showed compassion. So did Robert. Where's yours?
I used it all up. You don't know how long this has been going on.
Anna, this is the most important moment of your future, so why don't you just go up to the heart of it, all right? Duke cannot tell you something about...
Cannot or will not.
It doesn't matter.
It does.
Look, just stretch your understanding. Anna, all I'm saying is leave the past in the past. Not only for your sake, but Duke's.
There's one thing, man.
What?
Secrets never remain buried forever.
Since I'm the only one in Port Charles who knows your secret, it probably will. Until it's time to be said out loud.
I wonder if Duke's can.
If you'll let him. Duke has a secret that he will not reveal to me. But aren't we all entitled to a secret that's in our lives? I never would have brought up your past unless I thought it would save your future.
I want more stories of castles and dragons in Scotland. More.
I can see Robin in your face.
Oh, I know. She's so happy. The joy she has in living every single day. I feel that right now. It's because of you. Sean, who told me that I was being very foolish.
No, you mustn't blame yourself.
It was fate that I found you. After this talk with Sean, I needed to get away, so I got in the car and I drove and drove, and this is where I ended up.
Isn't how funny how things work out?
Yes. Up until today, I wouldn't have agreed with you.
Well, what did you and Sean talk about?
Well, he told me that I was being unfair to you.
You know, I knew
like Batman, for one reason.
He said I should get off my high horse and that most of the things I was accusing you of, I had done myself.
I assume he was referring to your time with the WSB.
Yes. There was a time then, which I tried very hard to forget, when my life was governed by lies, and it affected a lot of people that were close to me.
All of that's behind you now.
I know, but he pointed out the fact that these people were willing to forgive me, and that I should show you the same courtesy.
I appreciate you telling me all of this. I also appreciate you need a relationship based on trust and understanding.
Yes, I do. But I understand that if there are certain things about Lorleanne I have to let go of, I will. And I understand also that your father died because he was trying to protect the secret.
I almost lost you because of that secret.
That's not the Duke I know now. I promise that I will never ask you another question about Lorleanne. Promise. Yes, I did. Finally, one of the perks of my job paid off. Get through to Philomena and Robin on the car phone, and I told them, not to worry, I'll be back tomorrow.
So the rest of the night is all ours, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Any ideas?
Yeah. A couple of things we haven't even tried yet.
Only two?
I think I almost lost you. Any idea how miserable I've been? I never thought I'd ever see you again, something not like this.
I'm not going anywhere. Not without you. Oh my gosh, you've lost weight. Haven't you been eating?
I missed Philomena's food almost as much as I missed you.
Oh.
I'm kidding.
Well then, I will cook you a wonderful dinner. A dinner anyway. We must have some things left over in the cupboard.
This is all the sustenance I need.
You've got a point there.
I have a better idea.
What?
Why don't I fix dinner for you? You while you run off and change out your traveling clothes into something more comfortable.
Right.
That way we won't have any interruptions.
Sounds like a good idea.
I don't want to waste 1 minute.
Find anything else. I didn't bring an overnight bag.
You've never looked better.
Oh, no. I'm slightly prejudiced about all that. But I don't mind.
You know something? I never stopped loving you, not for 1 minute.
I never stopped loving you, even though I tried. But I couldn't.
I know that.
How do you know that? I never gave you any indication.
What is this? You never took my ring off, did you?
No. And I won't. Ever. Ever.
Not all I need to say about you won't. Ever.
Mm-hmm. Anyway. Stay right there. We can do without dinner for now. I want to have a little talk.
I
Haven't we talked enough?
Nope. I want to talk about our engagement. Come on, sit down.
About our engagement?
Yes.
Well, it's not off already, is it?
No. I have a favour to ask you.
Ask anything you like.
All right, I will. Will you marry me?
I beg your pardon. Are you proposing to me?
I am indeed. Well, you've had 3 goes at it, and I thought I should have a shot.
Yeah, that's the point.
I'm serious about this, Duke. I really am. Whatever happened in the past doesn't matter anymore. All that matters is that we live our life together. Nothing's going to stand in our way. Nothing's going to come between us.
I'm thinking about Camelia.
Oh.
I'm a little worried about her. She says she understands that I love you and I always will. I don't know whether I believe her.
Sounds very dear of you to worry about Camelia. But I don't think you need to. I spoke to her. And she feels the same way that we do.
I just hope it's the truth.
She wants us to be very happy together. And she isn't going to stand in our way. Where'd you go?
It's left over from our last visit. You do remember our last visit, right?
Yes, of course I do. I tried very hard to forget. I nearly succeeded. Of course I couldn't. Not really.
Well, you know, what we have together isn't something that you can very easily force from your mind.
No. There's been wonderful times together.
Mm-hmm. Some better times to come. Lots of them.
I'm counting on it.
Did I tell you? I didn't, about my new job.
Nothing specific. Delicious.
Well, Sean has offered me a job.
Really? Working in the shipping line?
Yeah. That. And also this other new venture he's involved in.
Make sure it's legal, won't you? Sean has a charming habit of getting himself involved in shady deals.
Believe me, I have no intention of being involved in anything that is even remotely illegal.
Can't wait until you've got this debt paid off that you're so obsessed with.
It's very important to me,
isn't it? I know. It's important to me, too. Because you can't just let marriage until it's all behind you.
It won't take long.
Yeah. Another thing that's worrying me. All these jobs you're doing and long hours. Probably going to take a toll on your health.
I know what I'm doing.
Talking about your health. Shouldn't we get some food on you?
No. We can eat any time. Tonight's not to be wasted on such mundane matters as food.
Oh? And what lofty matters are we going to be attending to?
I, madam, am going to make love to the most beautiful woman I ever laid eyes on.
Be like this.
You won't get any argument from me on that.
Your sister's here with you.
You are safe.
Mm. never want to stop feeling like this.
You never will. I'm so grateful that you're understanding enough to get through this difficult period.
It wasn't really a matter of me understanding anything. I just had to put the past where it belongs. And I'm never going to let the past hurt us again.